AI tools are moving fast, and so is AAVA. In a previous video with Action Apps, I showed you their AI-powered chatbot AAVA and how it can generate charts and insights from your athlete data with a single prompt. But now AAVA has leveled up with an improved user interface and, crucially, a conversational chat mode. AAVA chat remembers your context and builds on your queries. So in this video, I'll show you how that transforms the way that we can explore and visualize sports science data. Welcome back. I'm Jo Clubb, sports scientist and founder of Global Performance Insights. And today we're diving into the latest version of AAVA from Action Apps. So if you saw the first video, you'll know how easy and powerful it was for generating insights from GPS, VALD or other sports science data with just a single prompt. This is an AI-powered chatbot, which is driven by large language models, trained specifically on your team's data and providing you with the opportunity to interact with your data using everyday language. AAVA is ultimately designed to improve data exploration, to make it more simple, more efficient, and more effective. It can give you the ability to ask ad hoc questions of your data and get an instant response, which is allowing us to move away from solely looking at either rigid reports or having to take a really long-term deep dive, normally with the help of a data scientist, to uncover the answers to these questions that come up day to day. So it's allowing us the ability to ask questions of our data without necessarily a specialized data coding or data science skill set. This new update then takes it even further with a conversational chat mode. And that means that AAVA chat can keep track of your earlier requests and add layers of context without you having to repeat yourself. So let's jump in and see how it works in practice. So we have an improved user interface already, and we can see that we would have chat history along the bottom here, and we are in Ask AAVA mode. So I have in here with Action Apps then some fabricated soccer data, GPS data, and then also some VALD data in there as well. So we're just going to start simple and ask to show the total distance by player for the last game of last season. And you can see up here that that is running, and now we get our response. We have our chart, our visualization. We have a data table if we want to understand the underlying data. If we are interested in the code, perhaps if you're learning to code yourself, then this would be really useful to see how it came up with the response. And then we also have a nice little narrative summary here. If we are creating reports or something like that, that we then want to summarize in an email or provide a summary in a message alongside a report, because that's how some of our key stakeholders prefer the information, then this narrative summary will be really useful. So let's go back to our chart then. We can see instantly then that it's given us a total distance by player for that particular game that we asked for. Very conversational tone, asking for the last game of last season. We don't have to specifically state what date it was, what opponent, what season we're talking about. AAVA knows the context of that already. Clearly, we've got a couple of substitutes down here. So actually, I'm going to say remove the players that played less than 80 minutes. Again, we can see our little icons running through up here telling us that AAVA is thinking about our question. And then we get our response below with Richardson and White then removed. And instantly, this highlights that I haven't had to state or repeat my initial prompt around it being total distance, around it being the last game of last season. I haven't repeated any of that contextual information, but AAVA knows that we're now in a conversational format, and that's what I'm referring to when I'm just adding on this additional layer. We can see also we have chart controls over here then, and we can toggle through different chart types manually with these options. But we can also prompt for our visualizations using our chat feature. So now I'm going to ask to add meters per minute as a line on the secondary Y axis. We can see it running. You can see my query here, add meters per minute as a line on the second y-axis. And again, no need to repeat the earlier prompts. We have still our total distance for those athletes in that game, but now we have our line chart showing the average meters per minute on our secondary axis over here. So now I wanted to dive a little bit deeper into a particular player. So I've said, show me meters per minute for each game last season for Eric Rogers. And you can see then that we get a line graph of our meters per minute. And again, if we wanted to, we could go in to the data and query the table as well. I can add additional prompts relating to the visualization into the AAVA chat. So here I'm asking to add a marker on the existing chart for games where he played less than 90 minutes. And you can see already then we've got this different colored series here highlighting the games where Eric Rogers played less than 90 minutes. If we wanted to take a little bit of a deeper dive into that, of course, we have our interactive data labels here. We can highlight a certain portion if we'd like to zoom in and see that and then zoom back out. And we also have the option of viewing the underlying data itself in the data table. Perhaps now I want to add an average line and see if the chatbot is able to understand that query and adjust the visualization. And we can see there then instantly we've got the average meters per minute. So now I've got a new query. I want to look at, let's say, max velocity. And although I'm still going to look at some game data, obviously in this specific chat, I have excluded certain players based on their playing time. So any example like that where I want to start afresh, then I'm just going to go to a new chat. I've a query to ask for the max velocity by player for each game from last season and displayed as a box chart. You can see then we get our box plot here for our players. And actually, again, with our interactive hover, we can get the descriptive statistics from the box plot in terms of the different quartiles. And we see that it has color-coded it in this case based on the player name. So I'm wondering if I can actually change this to be based on position. So this isn't exactly what I want, but then that's a reflection that my prompt is not specific enough. So let me see if I can correct it. It's giving me by games along the x-axis. So I then said, okay, display by player name along the x-axis, which is what I've got, and also group according to player position in the legend here. We can see it's both color-coded that and provided this legend. And as I mentioned earlier, we can zoom in interactively here. We can hover to see the specific statistics. I double-click to come back out. Also, the legend is interactive, so perhaps I want to see what's pink, the central midfielders. I actually double click here and it just selects them. And again, this is their max velocity, so I can see the spread for each player for their game day maximum velocities. Or I can actually do the opposite, remove them, remove our other midfield groups and take a look at some of the other playing groups. Next up, I want to look a little bit more over time with some of our training load data. So I'm asking for Alan Poster, his high speed running over time. So there we get our full entry. So now I'll say to only display 2024 data and see if that simple prompt can be understood here by AAVA. Okay, great. Now we've got our line chart for just 2024 of Alan Foster's high speed running over time. Maybe I want to change this into a bar chart. I have the option here of doing it in the chart controls or typing it in as a prompt. Next up then, I wanted to add a little bit more context. So I prompted it to color code by day type, and we can see here then that we've got our periodization color coded for Alan Foster's high speed running. And that just adds this extra layer of context. Now, I know there's a few ratios and various calculations as well built into AAVA. So I'm going to ask it about the acute chronic workload ratio, of course, a very controversial topic. One I have a video diving into in terms of whether you should or shouldn't be using this. But for the sake of this demonstration, let's see if AAVA is able then to calculate our acute chronic workload ratio and overlay it as requested onto this chart on the secondary axis. So here we can see then that it is indeed able. So obviously a lot going on here and just playing around with these prompts, but we do have then our acute chronic workload ratio for our high speed running for Alan Foster based on these simple prompts. So I know there's also VALD data in here. So I've asked for the average jump height by player, and you can see it's returned here our charts. Again, I can pop into the table. I could also actually download this table or any of the tables as a CSV if I wanted to then play around outside of the AMS in Excel. So now I've gone back to looking at our data in a box plot format to see the underlying data. I can see we've got one athlete here who clearly has some incorrect data in here. Let's see if I can remove him then. So Jack Edwards. And see if we can get this box plot again with just him removed. And as we explored before, we have this interactivity where we can zoom in and understand that in more detail. So now I want to dive even deeper into one athlete. So I've chosen Alice Gray and asked for her average jump height and relative peak power by month. But actually, I probably want to put one of these series on the secondary axis. So there we have the average peak power, relative peak power. And that's an example of where AAVA is smart enough, has been programmed to understand some of the differences in metric names. I've just said relative peak power, and that everyday language is associated in the system with the specific metric name, which in this case is peak power divided by body mass, BM. And then I thought, actually, let's look into a scatter plot, which is another function we have here for our visualization. So I've plotted jump height against relative peak power. And in this case, I wasn't quite sure, is AAVA still using Alice Gray specifically, or has it reverted to all athletes? But again, I can go into our data set here and clearly see that it's still based on the prompt specifically for Alice Gray. And then, of course, we can also use AAVA for player comparisons. So here I've asked for jump height for two athletes over time in 2024 season. And then I can add even more context here. As you can see, the average line that has been added in response to this request. So that's a look at the upgraded AAVA in action. A smoother interface, conversational memory, and the ability to move from simple queries to deeper contextual layered insights in just a few prompts. If you'd like to know more about Action Apps or AAVA, I'll put a link to Action Apps' website in the description below. And if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe so you don't miss out on another Sports Science Insights video coming very soon.